Hey guys, sorry today is complete and utter chaos for us because it is our anniversary weekend for 3 years. And normally I don't show you guys my before with makeup and everything, but I'm gonna try and hurry up really fast before hubby kills me and we're late for everything today. So I'm just gonna go through my process and I hope you guys enjoy.
I am in no way, shape or form a makeup artist, nor am I good at it, or at least I don't think so. I am as beginner gets with makeup. I literally just do what I can to get by and look decent so I can go out and feel human. Excuse my little guy, Giovanni. He loves to make appearances and mess up mommy off camera. But I already had my skin prepped and moisturized. I used the primer by Milk. And I use moisturizer by Mary Kay because I do have extremely dry skin and I feel like I could never get enough moisture. So I had done that already off camera, and the foundation I'm using is by Anastasia. It is in a sample, as you saw, because I never like buying anything until I see how it works with my skin. So thanks to Sephora, shout out to Sephora, I was trying it out for the very first time and I really did like how it blended with my skin. It feels very silky and pretty moisturizing too. It didn't flake up like I've had some foundations do in the past. And for this concealer, I'm using Kat Von D, which I've used for quite a while and it's never let me down and is always hidden my mom bags, as I call it, from countless sleepless nights. Now to eyebrows. I love this pencil. So sorry guys, it didn't come out on the video, but it is by Penelope Lyons. She is the reason why I have eyebrows at all, because I did do the microblading. I was extremely terrified to try it, but it definitely is worth it because now I have a template that is so easy to fill in instead of having to start over and recreate brand new eyebrows every single time. Like, that was such a huge time saver and I'm so glad I did it. And I did it in a really light shade for that reason, because I didn't want it to be more defined or darker than I wanted it to. But at the same time, I can fill it in, make it as dark as I want. But if I'm lazy or not feeling it, then I at least have some kind of eyebrows, which for me is a huge win. And I'm sure you guys have gone through the same exact struggles as I am. I've been getting so much love and feedback from other women who have alopecia and hair loss like myself. And it's amazing. Keep it up, guys. Comment. Let me know. I'm always available. Email me any questions. And that's why I'm doing this video, because I wanted you guys to see my entire process. I normally just already have my makeup done before I start the install, but I felt it was important for you guys to see the whole thing because maybe it would help someone else that has a similar situation as myself. So again, I am in no way a pro, but hopefully this can give you some ideas on a very quick look to go out and about with that won't take a ton of products or a ton of brushes to achieve. And yes, I do normally use my fingers, as you saw, for the foundation, because for me it just feels the easiest. With brushes, it can feel a little rough on my skin. I have very sensitive skin and I feel like I don't waste as much product, so I kind of like the ease of that. And with this palette, I believe it's by Natasha, it's a mini sunset, and I love it because it's all nude type colors, and to me that is the easiest to get a pretty good look out of because you can't really mess it up. All of the browns, golds, nudes blend together, but you can still achieve different looks depending on how you're feeling and what your day will consist of. So you can have a really easy and chill day look or jazz it up for nighttime. So I feel like I kind of tried to strike a middle ground here for our anniversary night, because we were going out to a really nice and fancy steakhouse. So I wanted to look my best, but I'm sure you guys probably feel the same way, but I had no idea how this was going to look as I was doing it. I was like, oh my god, this might be too dark. But once I went in with this shimmery gold, things started to kind of clear up for me, and I could see the finish line. I was like, okay, this isn't too bad. So let me know what you think. If you have tips, I am all for it. Please let me know what's easiest for you, what brushes you like, what products you like, because I'm always looking for something that will work with my skin. Again, I'm super dry and my skin is just so sensitive, and that's why I normally don't do makeup on a regular basis, because I will break out. So let me know. I'm definitely looking forward to your feedback. This cream eyeliner stick is my go-to look for my waterline because it's so easy to apply and get a really nice eye-opening glow. And for my eyeliner, I definitely struggle with this, guys, as I'm sure all of us do, but I did both eyes in a different way. So one, I tried from the inner corner out to the cat eye or flick. Sometimes this is easiest for me, but I've been finding that I've been wanting to learn how to really angle the cat eye, and I think it's easiest to do that by starting from the flick, because then you can set your angle and from there you can build and not have it too thick. So I would definitely recommend trying both and seeing which one works for you. But don't worry about messing up, because I mess up all the time. That's what Q-tips are for. And after you're done, you can always just touch up with a little bit of your foundation or your concealer, brighten it up, and clean the area. Let me know which side you think turned out better. In this look, I was using one of my other brush type liner, but I do have another one from Kat Von D that I think is a little easier, especially on the go, because it's in a stick form and it's just easier to control. I think it's the tattoo liner, and I definitely recommend using the brush tip instead of the felt, because the felt is so rough and sometimes very drying, and you'll end up peeling up the layers when you try and go over it several times. So I definitely like the brush over the felt. Now, if you haven't seen my last video, Moxie Lash has become my ultimate favorite because I could never do regular strip lashes. It was such a headache. And after all of that work, it would end up pulling up on the corners. So for anyone like myself who does not have eyelashes, I definitely recommend trying it out, because it has given me hope and it's so much easier to do my lashes now. Here I'm just going in with some face powder. I actually bought this with the intention of using it for my lace on my wigs and every now and then when I wanted to blend it in a little more, but I see that it does help me not be as shiny on camera from all of my moisturizer. And I'm just going in with my mini bronzer from Fenty Beauty. Again, not sure if I'm doing this right, but I do find it helps add a little bit of color and a very light contour without going too crazy. I've been really practicing on my highlighter skills. I kind of struggle with getting the right amount because I don't want it to be too strong, but I still want a little glow, so it'll take some time, but I'm gonna keep trying. And there's my little guy again. Little Menace was trying to bring down my camera, but if you guys have kids, you totally understand. So
So this was basically it. Now I'm just going to top it off with some lip gloss. I'm sure you guys have seen, and they probably still are, but Victoria's Secret was having a huge sale, and these lip glosses ended up for $3 each. It had been a really long time since I had done a lip gloss, and I was really surprised by how much I would like it, because I've been so into the matte lipsticks, but they can tend to be super drying. So this is a super easy look, a little bit of color. And then I mixed it with just a little extra shimmer and pop, but I love them and they definitely smell good. Now that my look was complete and the magnetic eyeliner was dry, I went ahead and applied my Sassy Lashes. It's definitely a little bit of a learning curve because of how it just snaps on. So I do tend to adjust them over and over, but that's another thing I love, is the fact that you can, if it's not exactly to your liking. I think over time I've realized I prefer starting from the end of my eyelid, so I know exactly where I want it to be, and then it lines up a little bit easier. But play around with it. The magnets are very strong, so if you want it tilted a little bit more up, you kind of have to angle it on your application, and then it's perfect. It stays put all day long. Now I'm gonna go in with my Mary Kay translucent powder. This is a step that I've been trying to remember to use in my routine. It's another step that I'm not too comfortable with, and I'm still figuring out as I go, but it does help me kind of stay less shiny in some of the areas. So again, if you have tips on these, please let me know. I'll be so happy to put them into use. Now just for a little body shimmer, I'm using the Fenty highlighter in Cinnamon. And my collarbones used to be a trouble area for me that I thought were just awkward and stuck out. But now I love them and I like to show them off with just a little bit of shimmer. Not too much, not too crazy, but just a little extra pop and glow. So if you want to try that out, I definitely recommend it, and it's so easy to do. And that's it, guys. Again, let me know what you think and if you try out this look. Moving on to this gorgeous and luscious hair, it is an 18-inch water wave, and it was my first time with such a soft curl, but I really, really liked it. On the inside, you have the full 6 inches of parting space down the center, and of course, the regular adjusting straps on the base. I always put mine in the middle for extra snug fit, of course, because I don't have hair, that definitely comes in handy. And then you have these tabs on the side to put in your elastic band, which again is just another aid to keep it a little bit more snug. But if that's still not enough, I do like to use my wig grip headbands every now and then if I think it's going to be a really crazy and active day and I don't want to use any glue, then that comes in handy. Now I normally forget to cut this part off, or at least show you guys that I'm cutting it, but I always do it off camera. And because I was rushing and I don't really care about the bottom base because I don't tend to pull up my hair, I did cut it pretty rough and hastily, but it's okay. If you do want to pull your hair up, then definitely take your time on this part so you don't cut away any of that baby hair. So it turned out I ended up with the wrong size somehow. And guys, I have no idea how this happened, because I always wear a size small. But nonetheless, I decided to make it work, and I wanted to show you guys anyway, if you do already have a wig that's too big, or if that's your issue with a newer wig you just had, you can make it work and make it fit your head and customize it. But it does take a lot more work because you have so much excess lace on either side. I'm using my foam just to get the baby hairs out of the way so I don't cut them off. But when it comes to the sides of your ear, to me that's the most important step of customizing your wig and getting it to lay flat, because if it is bumping into your ear or overlapping, you're not going to get a really good flat install. Whether you're using glue or you're using hairspray, it is going to fight you the whole way. And not to mention, it's uncomfortable. You will end up fidgeting with it all day if it's rubbing on your ear. So if you're using shears, start from the beginning line of your ear and just follow it straight up, and that'll give you a really clear idea of where you need to cut it. But don't worry if this takes you forever. I know it does for me because I'm very, very, very picky and I want it to fit perfect. So I tend to continue touching up on these areas and tweaking it as I go. So don't worry if it takes you several times or you find yourself constantly going back over the same places and cutting, because I do the same thing. Now I'm just going in with a baby wipe and some rubbing alcohol. Baby wipes are my go-to, probably because I'm a mom, but they seriously work for everything, and it's perfect for sensitive skin because they don't have anything on it. But it's just so any type of adhesive that you are using, or if you're using hairspray, it will help it grip better to your skin if there aren't as many oils. So after putting a layer of the Got To Be Free spray, I am going in with the sculpting gel as well, because I find that combining the two just gives you an extra stronghold, and I definitely needed that because of the size of the wig. I really wanted it to be glued down. So for me, I like to bond the lace pretty much immediately after putting a couple of layers of the hairspray and maybe one layer of the gel, not too much because it is thicker, and then holding it down with either the side of the comb. And this time I did opt to use the blow dryer on a cool setting because I was in a rush, so I wanted to hurry along the process so it can fully dry. Now to give you a close-up, I definitely recommend always using a heat protectant anytime you are going to put heat on your hair, whether it's for straightening or curling. And I'm going in with the hot comb to help flatten out the roots a little bit and also give me a clearer idea of the hairline. Now, mirror placement is really, really important, guys. For this video, we're such in a rush and really trying to make the angles work so you could see best, that I could not really see what I was doing. So you can clearly see me cutting some of the baby hair, but that is okay. When it comes to wigs, it's really not about perfection. It's really the imperfections that make it look the most natural. So as you are cutting your lace, make sure you do not cut it in a straight line. You want to zigzag if you can, using the up and down motion of the shears or the eyebrow razor. So that way you can get a very uneven and kind of jagged look, which is how most people's hairlines are. Nobody has a perfectly straight hairline. So it's okay if you cut some of the hair, don't freak out. Again, just take your time. It was a very, very hectic day for us with a lot going on and needing to drop off the kids, so I was making all kinds of mistakes. But that's why I like making these videos, because I want you to see that regardless of mistakes or struggles, you can still get an amazing look.
and it's going to take some practice. I've been wearing wigs for a long time and I still mess up, so nobody's perfect. Don't worry, just keep at it, and it's all in the details. Take as much time as you need. So I'm using the edge brush, which I really love because of all the different tools on one brush to help you smooth back any baby hair around the hairline. And I like the Eco Styler Gel because it doesn't flake up and it's not a super crunchy hold. Again, I know baby hair is not for everybody and that is okay, but I do find that if you did mess up in any areas or around your lace, it does help camouflage any flaws and also just gives you another extra pop, a little extra style, whatever you may like. Sometimes I just like doing accent baby hairs on either corner, and other days I will go around the entire border. It doesn't matter, baby hair or not, it's totally up to your preference and what you like. Now, looking back on it, because this wig was big for me, I would recommend starting from the center. If your wig is ever loose, bonding down the center of it makes it a little easier to get a seamless install all the way through, because sometimes starting from either edge, you'll end up getting this lumpy or wavy type look in the center because it's hard to pull the lace tightly. Hopefully that makes sense. But if you start from the center and you get a really flat base, then it's easier to pull from there to either side and get it seamlessly across. Now, I was trying out a different method here. I've seen quite a few girls start to use the hairspray directly on top of the lace, and I kind of had a love-hate reaction to it because spraying it on top does get a lot more of the product into your hair and hairline, and because of that, it ends up pretty rock solid. Like, that hairspray is no joke, and I wasn't a fan of the crunchy look. No matter how much water or how much I tried to brush it out, it still felt pretty rough. So in a way, it is a little bit easier because you know where the hairline is and how you spray it, but even when it comes to the cutting, you end up adhering a lot more lace to your skin than you actually need. So then when you want to cut it, you have to peel it back, and that tends to lift up the edge, and then you have to go back in with your rat tail comb or with your finger and try to lay those edges back down. So overall, I think it's a less of a complicated process if you spray your glue or your hairspray or whatever you're using underneath the lace first and then bond it down. At least it was for me. If you guys have tried out both methods, let me know which one you like. I'm just going in and softening up some of the baby hair because you don't want a very sticky, crunchy look. You want it to look effortless, but after styling it, it will hold its shape. So you don't necessarily have to do that all the time, and you can cut and trim the baby hairs because they do come longer than you need, so that way you can customize it. But just make sure to cut less than more. Less is always better because you cannot put that hair back. So be careful, take your time. first, I thought I wanted a sleek look on one side, so I used these really cute rose gold pins, and I wanted to show you what that look was like, even though I decided not to keep it because for some reason it just wasn't working for me and it wasn't staying as sleek as I wanted it to, but I wanted you guys to see it anyway. But when it comes to this hair and this HD lace, it is truly flawless. It comes pre-plucked, pre-bleached, so you don't have to do those extra steps. And the hair is just beautiful. I loved the effortless curls. It was very natural. You could definitely wear it how it was with a little bit more body and a little less definition. But if you want to, you can get that semi-wet look by just adding some product. Here I use some Garnier Fructis, which smells amazing, gives it the definition and stays very soft and also helps with some frizz control as well. And that's it, guys. Let me know what you think. It is available for purchase on Vanali.co, so go check that out. This is still considered a fake scalp because of the pre-bleached and single knots. And I also have one that has the bald cap type method on the inside. So go check those out. You can get either in this texture. Again, it is a water wave 18 inch. And let me know what you guys think. Thanks, guys. See you next time.